Hi everyone, this is a quick tutorial on using and connecting your Logitech C920 to your desktop. And this would be actually regardless of whether it's a desktop or a laptop computer. So unfortunately, this is not an unboxing. I've had this camera for quite some time, but I've recently received questions with regards to setting it up, so I just decided that I would do a short tutorial to walk you through that process. So this is the camera, and typically I connect my camera to my desktop, and I'm just going to show you how I connect it. I'm gonna try to hold on. Just make sure that I'm putting it there as good as possible. So it's connected and it is plugged into the back of my computer. This is actually the cable. Actually, no, this is the cable. This one is the actual cable for my camera. So the next thing that you need to do, you literally take it out of the box. And it is available to you almost immediately. The next thing that you need to go and do is go on to their support website. Their information is in their documentation that comes with your camera. And after you've been able to do that, you go on to the website, you go to the page that it directs you to go to, you then can pull down their PDF setup guide, and you can go to downloads. And from here, you're able to actually get the software program. So you won't need the gaming unless that is what you're going to be using this for. So otherwise, you would go to the Logitech webcam software and download that onto your computer. Once you've downloaded that onto your computer, this is what that software looks like. And as you can see right now, it says that no webcam is detected because I unplugged it. And I should plug it back in. Let me make sure everything is cope. Oh, there you go. It's plugged back in now. So now you can see that it is plugged back in. So this is what the software looks like once it's actually plugged in. And then what I could do is click on Quick Capture, because with this software program, you can also, and that's the camera there. With this software program, you can also record directly to it so that you would then be able to hold or save your recordings onto this particular software program, but I never use it that way. Over here, it gives you all of your capabilities in terms of being able to zoom. As you can see, I was able to zoom in, and then you can move from left to right. You can position yourself the way that you need to in order to make sure that it's capturing you. Make sure that it's capturing you. Sorry, I needed to adjust my lighting a little bit. Make sure that it's capturing you correctly. This particular webcam also comes with audio. So if I wanted it to capture that mic, you can see that it's right here. But normally I use this mic, which is my AT2020. So I very rarely, if ever, use my the microphone that is embedded into the webcam C920. And that is literally it. That's all that you really need to know. You get yourself set up with the camera. You make sure that I always, when I'm going live, particularly when I'm doing a Facebook Live, what I tend to do is I will open up the software, make sure that I have enough space above my head, that the formatting is correct, that I'm sitting properly. I'm going to move this over here so that I am not literally looking to the side all the time. And so I'll just adjust myself so that I'm centered and that my framing is correct, because you don't want your head to be too much cut off, but this is actually fine. You do like to have a little bit of headroom, but as far as this is fine for if I'm doing live streams. If I'm doing recording myself for a pre-recorded video, I do the framing a little bit differently. But I'll just come in here really quickly and I'll set myself up, and then I close this out And then I go into Facebook to live stream from there, because the Facebook live stream will not work. It will not find your camera if the Logitech or any camera. I don't know what camera other people might be using, but whatever camera, if your computer is already pulling in your information from that camera, then Facebook isn't going to be able to do that. So you have to close this out after you've just checked to make sure that the lighting is good. Like, I don't have my main light on right now. So I look a little dark. Maybe this side is fine because I do have a light coming from this way. I do have a window that's open this way, and it is illuminating me a little bit, but not enough. But I normally have a light that shines directly, not literally on me, but it mainly bounces off of my backdrop a little bit, but it lights me up better than I am right now. So I just come on here to make sure that the framing is correct and the lighting is good. And then from there, I close this out and then I go to Facebook and then I do my live stream from there. So anyway, so I hope that this was helpful to you. If you have any questions, feel free to pop them in the comments below and I'll see you later. Video marketing enables businesses to increase brand awareness and gain clients. If you're not sure what you need to do or how to go about doing it, then you need to schedule a free 30-minute consultation with me. During this consultation, we will discuss your current marketing plans and how video can help with engagement, awareness, and increasing your bottom line. If you're interested, sign up at www.virtuallyinsync.com/learn more. Thanks again for watching, and I look forward to hearing about your video success.